Hi, this is Brian, KB8UIP and VE3SPG. We have ARRL Field Day starting this weekend. It's now Friday evening. So just wanted to write up some Field Day tips. So first off, Field Day has its own website. So all the links will be in the description of the video. But here's the website. So just wanted to take a quick look and see what's here and what's available. It's got the Field Day Locator. I think I might already have it up. Here we go. So you can just zoom in on your part of the country, and you can see what's happening. We're down here in San Diego, and you can just like click on any of them to see kind of they have contact information if that's interesting for you. So there's the Field Day Locator. There's the rules, and here's the rules for the contest that are going on. What will be interest to you are the classes and the sections. So the classes are, there's class A. Those generally are club or three or more people. Class B is one or two people. All these are pretty much portable except like the home station and I guess the emergency operation centers. But either portable or battery. Class C is mobile, and then class D is what I'll be operating, which is a home station. Class E, home station emergency power. Class F, emergency operations section or center EOC. But anyway, in the rules, each of the classes is explained. You know, battery power, not battery power. Whether you get a free extra transmitter, or VHF, or whatever, it's all in there. And then the next thing, so you'll need to know like what class you're transmitting as, and then people will be telling you their class. You know, I'm I'm A or 1A or whatever, and they'll also be using a section. So what is a section? So let's see what we got here. As a locator, that was the rules. Here's the URL for the ARRL sections, U.S. and Canada. But the section can be like a state two-letter designator. But for instance, I'm in San Diego. It's actually SDG, so that's my section. And so when you actually have an exchange with someone, a QSO, and in my case, I'll have one transmitter. I'll be at home in San Diego. If I was doing voice, like single sideband or what's called phone, I would say since I have one transmitter and I'm in class D, which is a home station, I would be 1 Delta San Diego, 1 Delta San Diego. But if I was doing Morse code or CW, I'd be 1D SDG, so 1 Delta San Diego. So that's my class and my section. So those will be the things that you'll hear, over the air. And if you don't state them, someone might ask you like, "What's your section? What's your class?" So that's what that's all about. So let's see what's helpful. So the entry form, so you'll be keeping a log throughout. But what was cool about, if you take a look at the entry form that's here on the Field Day page, what's helpful is that if you go down here to the bottom, there's a go to data entry. So if you check that out, see the page is loading up. What's kind of cool is that it kind of shows you a lot of the information about the contest. So here's a little, almost like a little cheat sheet, right? Like what are the classes, what are the power sources, battery, solar, commercial, whatever, power multipliers. Oh, okay, so if you use 5 watts or less, you can multiply your score. So this is almost like a little cheat sheet, even though this is the entry form. Kind of tells you like how you can get points. So if you use emergency power, media publicity, public information available, all kinds of stuff. So you can just kind of go through this. And just by going through the entry form, you kind of get an idea of how you submit the information for the contest. Here's the band and mode QSO breakdown. So after you do all your QSOs, how many were CW, digital, phone, what was your power? So you're keeping track of all this as you go. And I think GOTA is just get on the air. So this is just letting civilians or other people, visitors, whatever, get on the air. So that's what that is. So that's that form. You'll notice here, let me show you right here, this band mode QSO breakdown. There's a little spot here to choose a file and upload dupe sheet or Cabrillo file. So for these kind of contests, you have to submit them in the Cabrillo file format. Although I'm not sure about this, the dupe sheet thing. I don't know how that works. But anyways, the Cabrillo file format is a specification. And I think I've got an example up here. Let me find that for you. So here's a nice sheet that was written up by ARRL Steve, looks like Steve Kutso, and explains the Cabrillo format. So there's like a little header up top. Then all the QSOs, each one has its own line. And then I think, okay, that's like the response. So this little sheet, I've got the link in there, kind of explains it if you just kind of like a walkthrough of exactly, you know, what the format means, why are we doing this. But there are online tools like this one here on b4h.net. And let's see, this is WA7BNM Bruce Horns. And so you can actually fill this out. It's 3 pages long. You kind of go through it, and it actually creates the little text file for you. And then you can copy and paste it, put it in Notepad. You might be able to download it. But anyways, it'll actually help you create the file, because you're going to need it to do the entry and upload your form. So I think I covered everything. We covered classes. How do you know what class you're in? How do you know what section you're in? We talked about the exchange a little bit. Like there'll be, you know, you'll want to say what your class is and what your section is. Here's an example for phone, 1 Delta San Diego. I would be class Delta home station. I have 1 transmitter. I'm in San Diego. And if I was doing Morse code, 1 Delta SDG. We talked about the entry form a little bit. Classes, power source, multiplier, bonus, help info. Let's see, if we have time, I will show you. There is a little help button. Let me show you what that looks like. Okay, let me show you this. This is pretty helpful. So I'm on the field day page, and if you go to entry form, like we're going to submit our entry. Go to that. At the bottom, there's a go to data entry. So go there. And what you'll notice is that there's like little info bubbles. So if you click that, it actually takes you to this page where it's actually got all the little help or info bubbles on each one of the thing, like explains what's class A, what's class B. Super helpful. What really is emergency power? What's the definition of a public location? You know, what's the bonus? So it's got really good, like social media. When do you get the 100 point bonus for social media? So all that's in here. What's a go to station coach? So all kinds of good info if you just click the little info bubble. So I hope you found that helpful. If so, please go ahead, like, subscribe, and share. Good luck in the contest this weekend.